Hello everyone and welcome to the session 6 of unit 5, that is estimation in forging shop and foundry shop for the course estimation and costing. So in the last class we have discussed about the introduction to foundry shop and various allowances in the foundry shop. So today we are discussing the simple problems on foundry shop. So this is the first problem. Estimate the cost of 2000 cast iron pulley as shown in figure 5.12. So this is the figure 5.12. Its surfaces are to be machined after casting. So its surfaces to be machined after casting. So this is the final product. This is not the the casting product. This is the final product of the cast iron pulley required. So the original the original casting produced will be greater in sizes because we need to add various allowances for this. So this is the final product. So after machining. So, but we have to purchase the material for the cost at the after adding allowances, we have to remove the materials by means of machining and everything. So, the original casting is greater, larger in size compared to this size. So, by adding all the allowances, this is the final product. So, we have to pay the cost for the raw material size, which included all the allowances. So, we have to prepare a model or costing which includes all the allowances. So we have to calculate the material cost on that, not for this finished product. So that has to be remembered. So its surfaces to be machined. So its surfaces to be machined after casting. So the pattern is to be supplied by the customer itself. Following data can be used. Cost of the metal is rupees 5 per kg. Molds prepared by each worker is 20. So for day, the molds, the persons, each person prepares 20 molds per day. Melting charges is 20% on metal cost. Machining allowances is 2 mm. It is taken as 2 mm on each side. Wages of the molder is rupees 16 per day. So, since they are preparing 20 molds per day and you have to pay 16 molds, 16 rupees per day. So, cost of the salary of the each person per day is 16 divided by 20, 0.8. So that means if you are preparing 20 molds, we have to pay 16. If you are, they are preparing one mold, we have to pay him 16 divided by 20, that is 0.8. So density of the cast iron is 7.2 grams per cc. Overhead charges is 25% of the metal cost. So this is the 5.2 figure, which is final product. But if the surfaces are machined, so we have to produce a casting which is included the machining allowances. So we have to add 2 mm on each side. So if this is 11.26, we have to add 0.2 mm on each side, this side and this side. So 0.2 mm, 2 millimeter means 0.2 centimeter. So 0.2 centimeter here, 0.2 centimeter here. So the 11.6 will become 12 centimeter here. And for this 8.6, similarly, it will become 9 centimeter. And the 5.6 diameter will become 6 centimeter. So the length wise, so we start from this side, so 2 mm here, this side, so 3.8 will become 4 here, so 4, and 2 mm this side here, so we have already given machining allowances 2 mm this side, the 2 mm this side, so that will become 4 mm here. So again, we are making this, we are giving 2 mm allowances here. So what will happen, this will become 4.2 here, and this 2 mm we are again giving other allowances here. Again it will move forward, this reduced. So since it will go forward here, 0.2 will be reduced, that 0.2 will be matched here, so that dimension remains same here, 4 cm here. Why? Because we are adding 0.2 mm this side, 0.2 cm this side, so that it will become initially 4.2. After adding material here, 0.2 mm for extra allowances, this will move here, so that this 2 mm will be covered. Again, this will remain 4 cm only. So 4.2 cm, again we are pushing it 2 mm front, so that the 0.2 will be covered now, so that will become 4 only. So here we have added 2 mm here, so this side also we have to add 2 mm. So 4.2 this side and 2 mm this side, so 4.4 cm for this length. Hope you understood. This is 3.4, this is diametrical one, so we have to produce, we have to reduce the diameter for machining inside holes. So 2 mm this side and 2 mm this side, we have to include the material. So initially 3.4 minus of 0.4, 3 mm. So we have to machine and you have to become reduce it, increase its diameter to 3.4. So for hollow shape you have to reduce the diameter, for outside surface you have to increase the diameter. So 0.2 east side means 3.4 will become 3 cm since it is a hole. See here again I will tell you why this remains 4 cm. So see here, this 2 mm we are adding this side, so that will become 4 mm initially, and again we are adding 2 mm this side, so that it will go forward, so it will become 3.8 here. So it will remain 4. We are not considering 0.2 of this one, just we are considering 0.2 for this side. So 3.8 will become 4 here. So it will remain here only. So we are now adding 2 mm this side, so that will become 4, will become 4.2. so 4.2, again we are adding 2 mm here, so that will move forward here, so that 4.2 will be 2 mm will be covered here, so 4.2 will become again 4. So 2 mm here this side and 2 mm this side, this will become 4.4. so this is a lengthwise machining allowances. The final component will be like this. So you have to split this component into simple geometry. We have 4 parts here, 1, 2, 3, A, B, C, and a hole in D. So volume of A, this is a solid cylinder of diameter 12 cm and length 4.4. So pi d square by pi, 12 square by 4 into length 4.4, that will become 497.63. Volume of part B is pi 9 square by 4 into 4, and the volume of C is pi 6 square by 4 into 4, pi 6 square by 4 into 4, and volume of part D, that is a hollow one, pi 3 square by 4 into length, total length is 12.4. So 12.4 is the total length. This has to be deducted because this is a hole. So total volume will become A plus B plus C minus of D. So total volume will be 772.42. The cast iron density of the cast iron is 772.2 into 7.2 grams per cc, 7.2 grams per cc divided by 1000. We have applied for this, so that it will directly will obtain it in kg, 5.6 kg. So next, the cost of material cost is rupees 5 per kg. We require 5.6 kg. The material cost will be 5 into 5.6, that is rupees 28. We have to pay for the material cost. Next is the melting charges. Melting charges is 20% of the metal cost. So 20% of 28 is 5.62. In the molding charges, we have wages for each molder is 16 rupees per day. So they are preparing 20 molds per day. So for each mold, we have to pay him for 20 mold, we have to cross multiply here. For 20 mold, we have to pay 16 here. Cross multiplication. The wages, the persons are paying preparing 20 molds per day. Per day they are preparing 20 molds, and for salary for them is, for producing 20 molds is 16. That means we have to pay him pay them 20 molds, we have to pay him 16 rupees for preparing 20 molds, because they are preparing 20 molds per day. Per day salary is 16. After they are preparing 20 molds, you have to pay them 16 rupees. Then what is the cost of one mold? So 20 molds, 16 rupees. Then for one mold is X. So X equals to cross multiplication. So this will go here and this will come here. 16 divided by 20. 16 into 1 divided by 20. That will become here 0.80. So cost of molding charges per piece is, per pattern per piece is 0.8 rupees. We are calculating all those things for each mold. So after that we have to multiply it for 2000 because it is asked for, he has asked for 2000 the police. So overhead charges is 25% of the metal cost, 25% of the 28 is 0.7. The total cost is 28 is the metal cost, 5.6 is the melting charge, 0.8 is the molding charge, and 7 rupees is the overhead charge. So for each casting we require 41 rupees 40. So we have to prepare 200 such casting. So 2000 in 2000 such casting, 2000 into 41.40 is 82,800 is the total cost of the this casting. Okay. Thank you for watching this session.